I'm introducing the next speaker, Manuel Cáceres.
Hello.
Okay. Hi, Manuel. Please share your screen. Manuel is going to give the talk titled Safety in Multi-Assembly by Path, appearing in all path covers of a DAG. Please go ahead.
Thank you. So my name is Manuel Cáceres. I am a PhD student from University of Helsinki. And today I will present you how to compute safe paths for path covers in directed acyclic graphs and applications of this to multi-assembly. This is a joint work with my supervisor, Alexandru Tomescu, and also joined with researchers and professor Brenda Mumin, Entin Husic, Romeo Risi, Massimo Cairo, and Christopher Sachi. But first, I would like to talk about puzzles. So many problems in bioinformatics can be seen as puzzles, where we have only the pieces, and the objective is to build the entire puzzle. So for example, genome assembly that we have discussed here extensively until now. We have reads of some hidden genome that we don't know, and we want to reconstruct this genome from these reads. Another example is the multi-assemble, which is some sort of generalization of the assembly problem, where instead of only one sequence, we have different sequences. And we have reads mixed from all these sequences, and from this mixed set of reads, we want to reconstruct all the input genomes. So coming back to puzzles, some puzzles are solved perfectly. We can obtain the solution to this puzzle. And in general, in computer science, in theoretical computer science, we define the problems to be solvable. In theory, but in practice, we see that we encounter, for example, in bioinformatics, many unsolved puzzles. And in bioinformatics, this happens a lot because there is not only one solution that solves the problem that we are interested in, but there are many solutions. So which one we choose? So first, what we propose is, as a general framework, we're going to output only things that are for sure part of the real solution. The first thing that we could say naively is that we're going to output the input itself, because that is part of the solution, a sub-part of the solution. But we could do better also and try to output a bigger sub-part of the solution that we know for sure that will appear in the real solution. And we call to this part safe, and we want them as big as possible. So this in genome assembly are exactly what contigs are. Contigs are subsequences of the original sequence that we want to record, that for sure we know are part of the genome. And there are a lot of practical assemblers now reporting contigs. And also there is a lot of work theoretically that is not only interested in safe solutions, but only in complete. That this is how much we can report, what is the maximum amount that we can report. And I think a good work in this topic is what Sebastian already presented for the genome assembly problem. But in multi-assembly, the other problem I presented, this is not well developed, and this is what this work is about. So the model that we are going to use for multi-assembly is a path cover in a DAG. A path cover is just a set of paths such that every vertex of the graph belongs to some of these paths. And a DAG is just a directed graph that doesn't have directed cycles. For example, this is used in RNA transcript assembly, which is some instance of this multi-assembly problem, and also in viral quasi-species assembly. And we are going to talk more about this in a moment. We developed two types of path covers. We developed two models of path covers. The first model is minimum path cover. So we consider that a solution is a path cover with minimum size. And to this size, we call it the width of the graph, because we can compute it based on the graph. And we denote it by key K. And it is known that in a DAG, this minimum path cover can be computed in order B times E. But we also, for considering more practical constraints, consider a generalized version of the path covers, that it is a path covers whose size is at most a parameter of the problem that we call L. And also we restrict the paths to start at and end at given input subset of vertices of the graph. So this is a generalization of minimum path cover, because we could set here L equals K and S and T equals to the whole side of vertices. So I'm going to present you our results now. We have both theoretical and practical results. In the theoretical side, we present polynomial time algorithms for computing both safe edges and maximal safe paths for both model, minimum path covers and generalized path cover, in essentially the same times for both models. So in the case of edges, we have that this work is in order k times b times e, and for maximal safe paths, in order k squared times b times e. Now recall that k is the width of the DAG. And in the practical side, we apply this framework for multi-assembly to the transcript assembly problem, and we define something that we call RNA context in that context. And we perform a proof of concept study in this with perfect data and also non-solutions. We build splicing graph from human annotated transcript. And we found that compared to a simpler model, that our unitics or RNA contigs are double in length. We also found that the transcript coverage of the transcript is 80% by RNA contigs, and that all this for all transcript annotation runs in less than 15 seconds. So let's go now to theoretical results more in detail, and I will present this only for minimum path cover because of time constraints. So the general approach to obtain the maximal safe paths for this problem is first to compute a solution. Why we compute a solution? Because for a path to be safe, it has to be part of every solution. So in particular, it has to be part of some particular solution. So in this case, we compute a minimum path cover. We can do this, as I said, in order B times C. And then for each subpart of this solution that we have, so in this context, for every subpart of a path of the path cover, we test if this path is safe. So this is just a simple general approach. But this translates into computing the width of a reduction of this DAG based on this path that I'm going to show you in a moment. So let's start with safe edges because they are simpler. So for safe edges, we have this simple theorem that says that an edge is safe for the minimum path cover problem, if and only if the width of the graph changes if we subtract this edge from the graph. And the main idea here is that if we subtract an edge of the graph and the width doesn't change, it means that there is another solution that doesn't use this edge. And as such, this edge is not safe is not part of all solutions. So with this simple theorem, we have a naive algorithm for every path in the path cover. This is order k times b edges. We can compute the minimum path cover of this g minus e and obtain this grid and compare against this. So this is the naive algorithm, but we can improve, we can do better than this. So for improving this complexity, we use a lemma in a publication of McKinnon et al. That says that if you have a path cover of size t, any path cover, not necessarily of minimum size, you can obtain a minimum path cover in time proportional to the number of edges of the graph times the difference between what you have and the optimal solution that you want. And this is based on a reduction to maximum flow. So if we do this, when we are testing one or edges for safety, we can compute the width of g minus e instead of running again the minimum path cover algorithm. You can use this, and we obtain that the complexity of every edge is the number of paths that use this edge that we call mu sub e times the number of edges. And if we add up all the edges in the path cover, this complexity we obtain the order k times b times e. And this is basically the algorithm for computing safe edges. For maximal safe path, we could try to do the same. Instead, we did the same, at least in the idea of what we are doing. But now it's not as simple as removing the whole path, because if you remove the whole path, you are not allowing to use subpaths of this path as part of this solution. So instead, we have to do a little more work in this case. So we define something that we call the reduction graph of t respect to the path that we are testing to be safe. And this is just the same vertices. And for the edges, we remove the last edge. And we add these edges that we call transitive edges, because these represent taking the path, the proper suffix of the path. So here is to have a more graphic idea of what is happening. If this is the path, what we do is first we remove this last edge, and then for every incoming node to the path, we put this transitive edge that represents using this suffix of the path. And of course, we don't put the edge from the first in neighbors, the neighbors to the first vertex, because this would mean use the whole path that we would like to avoid in our test. So with this construction, we obtain an analogous theorem that is that we want to test a path if it is safe. And we know that its longer proper prefix is safe, then it holds that the path is safe if and only if, same as before, that the width doesn't change with respect to the original graph. So with this in mind, we again can compute a maximal safe path. And to do this, since we require that its longest proper prefix is safe, to be safe, then we can compute the paths in increasing size order. So first, the ones of size 2, which are safe edges, then the safe ones of size 3, 4, and so on. And with this approach, with this simple approach, and using the minimum path cover algorithm instead of shrinking, we can obtain this time complexity. But of course, we can again use this idea of shrinking of computing this width more efficiently, and also noting that in every path in the first solution that we have, there are at most a linear time of maximal solutions. So we can compute them all with a two-finger pass in that path. we obtain an algorithm that runs in order k squared times b times b. These are the theoretical results. In the practical side, we define RNA contigs. So for this, I'd like to recall the central dogma of molecular biology. So we have the DNA sequence here, and we have some sequences of this DNA called introns and some called exons. And these exons are, well, both are important, of course, but these exons are what end up then in as RNA transcript, which then become proteins. And this process from going to DNA to RNA is called transcriptions. That's what this called RNA transcripts. But also here, from going to DNA to the RNA transcript, it happened an event that is called alternative splicing, where exons of different parts are combined to form the different RNA transcripts. So the RNA transcript assembly problem asks to find the RNA transcript of a sample. This is the objective. And the input we have is our reads, but not reads from the DNA, but reads from the transcript. So from the reads from the transcript, we want to obtain the transcript itself. And so one known technique, which is genome-guided technique, is first to map these reads to the DNA or this RNA, if you want. So in this way, you can identify which are the exons that are part of your sample of transcript. And you can also identify that some of these reads align to maybe two exons. And this means that these two exons in some transcript are together in that transcript, are consecutive, I mean. And with this information, you could build the splicing graph, which is just a representation of this information where each vertex represents an exon and each edge represents some of these double mappings that we have in two exons. And this is a DAG. And naturally, by its definition, a solution to the RNA transcript assembly problem is a collection of paths in this graph, that it is a path coer of the graph. So if we go back to our definition of generalized path coer, we could use or L. Remember that we are interested in paths of size at most L to be 3, because in this case there are 3 transcripts. We also know where these transcripts start and where this transcript ends. And this can be, for example, in this case, identified by either upwards or downwards slopes in the mappings of the exon when we do this mapping here. So we can obtain those. So with this information, we have a generalized path cover. We model in this sense. We define the RNA contigs as the maximal safe path for this generalized path cover. So now I will tell you a little about what we did as an experiment, And we worked with human gene annotation with all the transcript information from chromosome 1 to 22 on the forward strand. This means that we already know the answer. So we have the transcript, which are the position of this transcript in the genome, and we also know what are the corresponding exons. So in a sense, we know the answer. That is why this is a perfect scenario, because we don't consider errors, and we already know the answer. And to experiment, since in practice we don't know the number of transcripts in our sample, or maybe we don't know them, we test L to be the minimum possible paths, the width of the DAG, until 2k, twice the minimum number. As a baseline comparison, We take ST Unitix, which are just an extension of Unitix, these paths in the graph that whose internal nodes have in degree and half degree equal to one. because that those are safe in the problem, because we have to cover vertices. So our results, the first result is that the algorithm runs in less than 15 seconds. And then we have this table here that tells about precision and relative maximum coverage. So in terms of precision, we know that for T and 2K, T is the real number of transcripts. We are 100% precise, which is what we expected because we are computing safe paths. But when we are not considering the real number of transcripts as part of the input, we see some loss in precision here. We can also see here the relative maximum coverage is how much of a transcript we cover with one of these contigs. And we can see that it is up to 80% in small graphs. And it's always better than Unitix. And in fact, this comparison between Unitix and contigs, it is shown here. So in general, we are 1.4 to almost 2 times longer than ST Unitix. So to end this presentation, I would like to make some conclusions. So we present some efficient algorithm that obtain all maximal safe path for generalized path cover for this definition that we have. We did a proof of concept of RNA contigs on human annotated transcript. Everything, the code, the dataset, and the manipulation script are available in this URL. And we also consider that future development of safe paths in generalized path cover is possible and it is worth. So for example, apply to other multi-assembly problems, not only RNA transcript assembly. It can be used also to validate current assemblies, and it can be used as a preprocessing step of the real assemblers, or just as contigs are used as simple as output of the multi-assembly problem. So that's my presentation.
Thank you very much. And I'm inviting people to ask questions. I have one in the chat. You mentioned alternative splicing. I guess you include other RNA maturation events, such as alternative start, termination, or transcription.
I'm not aware of what this means, but the nearest that I can relate to is parameters S and P that we have that we consider to give us as input of our algorithm a set where we know that the transcript starts giving the information we have according to the reads and where the transcripts end. I don't know the technical concepts, the names for.
So I think that I'm trying to interpret that question. It is what are the alternative splicing events that you have considered in your experiments?
Alternative splicing.
Well, what kind of events do you have?
Only the events that one transcript can be formed from different subsets of exons. That's what we consider.
So there is no restriction on the set of events?
No other than that.
Okay. Then from YouTube, if I understand well, you presented a graph resolution method. What is the expected quality of the input graph in terms of real data, technology, assembly method?
Okay, I have to read something to answer that. But I know that current assemblers have precision that is really low in terms. I think it was less than 50% of precision of current assemblers. Between 50 and 60%, of precision of current assemblers. But of course, these assemblers lead with real data issues as errors. And
yes, so yeah. I think that the question asks for what happens if the input graph is noisy.
I think the resulting the result will be different because we only tested in perfect scenario. But I'm not sure how it will behave. We haven't tested that.
No, that's fine. Another question is, how would the use of long reads affect the approach?
Okay, that's a good question. Because here, if you notice, our model considers only path core as a model, so we only require the paths, the transcript, to cover all the vertices, all the exons in that case of this graph. But we don't consider long reads. And long reads would mean to have sub-path constraints. That is to require to the path cover that a sub-path of the graph exists in the path cover. And we are at the moment working on that, so I don't have a definitive answer for that question. But okay. It's a really good research question.
Yes. Thank you very much. And I really appreciate your talk. So if there are no more questions, we are going to have a break.